We saw in the last video how in test crosses in Drosophila that involve the linked alleles, most of the offspring have parental phenotypes, but a significant number have recombinant phenotypes. We identified that the cause of those recombinant offspring was crossing over during meiosis. In this video, what we're going to do is look at the details. I'm Mr. W from learn-biology.com, where we believe that interaction and feedback is what leads to deep, substantial learning. We're so sure of that, that we provide a money-back guarantee that comes with your subscription. What happens in crosses involving linked genes? Why are there recombinants? In diagrams A and B, we have a dihybrid female and her germ cells. In C, we have meiosis one with crossing over. We have homologous pairs. They're going to get together. They're going to swap genes and the production of recombinant chromosomes. But notice that some of the sister chromatids are recombinant and some aren't. So now what we're going to do is we're going to complete meiosis. We're going to go through gamete formation. And when we do that, note that of the eggs that the female produces, two of them at letter H, they're recombinant. What do I mean by that? Well, they have B plus and they have VG. In other words, this chromosome is B plus VG plus, this chromosome is B VG. Well, the recombinant ones are the ones where those alleles swapped places. So this is a recombinant B plus VG, this is a recombinant B VG plus, but these two at letter I, those are parental. Right? They're just like the parents, B plus VG plus BVG. Now, over here, we have the male parent, who's a homozygote, and his gamete, he can only produce one kind of gamete. He's homozygous. He can only produce a gamete that has B and VG. Here's what happens with the offspring. Offspring N and P have recombinant phenotypes. In other words, they have, in this case, gray body vestigial wings, that's recombinant, neither of the parent looked like that, and this is black body normal wings. Again, recombinant, neither of the parent looked like that, but O and Q are parental phenotypes. O is gray body normal wings, and Q is black body vestigial wings. Why are there so many more parentals than there are recombinant phenotypes? It's because crossing over happens, but it happens at a rate that's dependent on the distance of these alleles on the chromosome. And so the closer two alleles are, the less they'll tend to cross over. And this frequency, which is, I believe, 17%, that represents the distance between the B allele and the VG allele on the fruit fly's chromosomes. At learn-biology.com, we understand why students struggle with AP Bio. It's a hard course, but we have a plan for your success. Go to learn-biology.com, sign up for a free trial, and complete our interactive tutorials and interactive AP Bio exam reviews. We guarantee you a 4 or a 5 on the AP Bio exam. See you on learn-biology.com. What's the relationship between the percentage of recombination and the distance between any two linked genes? The further apart any genes are on the chromosome, the higher the percentage of recombinant gametes. In the chromosome map above, genes A and E will recombine the most because they're the furthest apart. In other words, there can be crossing over over here, over here, over here, and all of those will get E to jump over here and big E to jump over here. That's going to look like recombination. That's going to actually almost look like independent assortment because they're so far away. But genes B and C, they'll recombine the least because the only way that they can cross over is if there's a chiasma right over here at this specific spot that would enable little c to jump over here, big C to jump over here, or B could do the same. The percentage of recombination can be used to calculate the map distance between two alleles. So over here, this is a chromosome map, and it's saying here that the distance between this long bristled appendages called long aristea and gray body, that's 48.5. Well, those are units that reflect the frequency of recombination. Over here between gray body and red eyes, that's a little bit under, that's 9 recombination units. And really what this amounts to is the frequency of recombinants. So doing all of these mapping experiments or doing all of these breeding experiments with fruit flies, the researchers at Columbia University in the 1900s, Thomas Hunt Morgan and his crew, were able to create maps of chromosomes. And this was establishing that genes are on chromosomes and was part of the pathway that ultimately led to the double helix and all that other great stuff. Note that these are not physical maps so that the numbers don't add up permanently, but this should get you far enough to have a basic understanding. Again, on learn-biology.com, I have a whole tutorial about linkage and recombination with practice problems that'll get you all the way there. Want to learn more? Sign up for a free trial of the website that guarantees your AP Biology success, learn-biology.com, and watch this next video.